Just like we did last time, let's find where 20 falls on this distribution. It's here between 7.8, one standard deviation away from the mean, and 22.6. So the z-score will be somewhere between 1 and 2. Let's find out what it is exactly. So we find the distance from the mean, which is now going to be positive, and divide by the standard deviation. We get that 20 is 1.46 standard deviations away from the mean. Now let's bring up our z-table. So like I said before, if we have our z-score, we'll find the proportion less than that z-score. So let's start with that. The proportion less than 1.46 is 0.9279, here at 1.4, and then the top of this column is 0.06. So if the proportion less than 20 is 0.9279, then the area above it must be 1 minus 0.9279, because remember, the total area under the curve will always be 1. This is 0.0721. So about 7.21% of students have gotten more than 20 points per post on average. If you've gotten more than 20 points per post on average, then you're in the 93rd percentile of students. Congratulations! Before we move on, I'm going to show you one more way to look at this. Since the data is symmetrical, then that means that the amount greater than 1.46 is equal to the amount less than negative 1.46. That means that we don't necessarily have to calculate the proportion less than 1.46 and then subtract it from 1. We could just find the proportion less than negative 1.46. And we find that the proportion less than negative 1.46 is the same thing that we calculated before, 0.0721.